little bit more to get used to it, but there we go. And now to return to the actual event, the adventures of Colonel Erasius as he explores Yharnam and tries to figure out the mystery of the blood and the moon and the blood and also blood and monsters and beasts and the hunt and old Yharnam and the gods and stuff. Yeah. So, I went on a bit of a blood drive. Because, hey, Namel, welcome back. So I went on a bit of a blood drive since last time, because I had kind of run out of health and blood vials and bullets, and needed to really go just farm up some more. And I absolutely hate farming. I didn't gain any new levels or anything, because Angry don't grind for levels. That's not cool. But I did actually make a few interesting discoveries, because I basically just started at the beginning of the game and scoured every area. And a few things seem to have changed. So before we jump back into where we were, which was fighting the blood-starved beast at the bottom of Old Yharnam outside the moaning chapel of absolutely nothing terrible happening, we're going to go and revisit some old areas, and I'm going to show you some of the more interesting stuff that I discovered. I also discovered stuff in my other playthrough, which is kind of funny, because I'm usually pretty good at scouring absolutely everything. So the first thing that changed is Yosefka.
Oh, well, hello. Splendid. Let me ask you a small kindness. You're soon off to hunt, I presume? Then, if you find any survivors, tell them to seek Yosefka's clinic. Upon my Hippocratic oath, if they are yet human, I will look after them. Perhaps even cure them. This sickness, these beasts, they are not to be feared. This time the night is long. I may be trapped here, but I should do something to help. I'll even offer a reward for your cooperation. Tempted? Well, off you go then.
Now the interesting thing is that's basically the same thing that the legless guy in the Odin Chapel said. You know, if you find a survivor, send them here and I'll take care of them. And it's sort of reminiscent of kind of a hidden choice in Dark Souls between good and evil of sorts. Where you either decide to help, you know, you go the dark route or you go the rekindle the flame route, one or the other. With Lucretia, I did confirm that you can send that old woman to Yosefka instead of sending her to the Odin Chapel. Odog 1970 is, have you found any or I just call him Odog. I don't know why I decided to give his whole name. Is asking, have I found any survivors? There was the woman we sent to the Odin Chapel. Now, here's another interesting thing I noticed. You can talk to this window. I sort of blundered into it.
Oh, you must be a hunter. And not one from around here either. I'm Gilbert, a fellow outsider. You must have had a fine time of it. Yharnam has a special way of treating guests. Well, I don't think I could stand if I wanted to, but I'm willing to help if there's anything that can be done. This town is cursed. Whatever your reasons might be, you should plan a swift exit. Whatever can be gained from this place, it will do more harm than good. You needn't concern yourself with me. I'm afraid I'm of little help now. But before I take this...
What the hell is that? When I talked to it last time, it just told me about...
You.
Holy fuck, did it just give me a flamethrower? Because So I talked to it as Lucretia.
What afflicted me was incurable.
And it...
But this time gave me hope. Their strange blood bought me time. I was most fortunate. Unharmed by the plague of beasts. I can even die human.
Okay. So, when I talked to it as Lucretia, it just told me about the layout of Yharnam, Old Yharnam, and sort of the relationship between them and the valley and stuff, which was interesting enough, but it appears to have, holy shit, it did! It gave me a flamethrower. Well, I'll be damned. It's much better than a torch! Need to go find something to try this out on. Hello, citizens of Yharnam. I'm conducting a series of scientific experiments. Oh, indeed. Oh, but it uses bullets. I bet that would work on werewolves. Davidson says I would bet that would work on werewolves. Mad Adventure is saying, how much blood does it take to power the flamethrower? Well, that's actually kind of funny you ask that, because it does appear to swallow my bullets, and from the lore I've read... Okay, it doesn't interrupt, though. Which, I would think, like, okay... being set on fire, kind of distracting. You'd think that would, like, maybe cause people to maybe pause and stop swinging their... swords and pitchforks. But, no, what do I know? Oh. Excuse me, sir, I need more bullets. Yes, thank you. I used them all up in my flamethrower. Which is exactly how flamethrowers work. Especially considering the bullets are made out of quicksilver and my blood. Oh, he managed to hit me before I killed him. Anyway, now, we're gonna go talk to my nemesis, Thing 1 and Thing 2 on the bridge up here. Excuse me. Hello, fellas! I have something you'll quite like- whoops! Sorry, I had the wrong thing equipped. Wait a second. Wait, time. No, you don't really mind it, do you? Doesn't bother you in the least. Okay! Huh. Really would have expected them to be more bothered than that. Dog hairs notoriously flammable. It's cool. I don't care. Alright, so... flamethrower interesting, but no help with today's problems. Now, oh, the other thing I noticed, and this is really an interesting pattern that I just sort of glommed onto and then tested out as I explored the whole city of Yharnam here. I'm actually very disappointed in the flamethrower now. I was so excited by the prospect of getting... Remember when the flamethrower cane guy came at me? Excuse me. I was talking. Bastard. Okay, when the flamethrower cane guy was talking at me, I was really excited about the idea that I might get a flamethrower. Oh, also, you can dash up ladders by holding the circle button. Discovered that. So, here's the other thing. Note the red lantern there. This is such an odd thing to notice, but... I do have such an eye for the visual detail now that this stuff sort of sticks out to me once I was paying attention. Gonna go up the street a little bit here. Excuse me! No! Just passing through. Pardon me. Strictly speaking, didn't need to kill you, but I know you're just gonna turn around and cause trouble if I don't. And you! You can stay right back there where you started. Where is it? Alright. Here's another door you can talk to. Notice anything?
Lads, you've come on. You'd open a door on a night of the hunt. Away with you. Now.
See, there's another one, I believe, right around this way. I could be wrong. I think there's another one here. Yeah, so the red lanterns are cues that people will talk to you inside that building. And actually discovered that there were one or two windows, because I didn't try to talk at windows, I only knocked on doors. But, like, okay, here's the crazy lady's house. Red lantern again. As near as I could tell, every place where you can talk to someone, there's a red lantern outside of it. Just funny little quirk. Alright, let's go back to the hunter's dream here. Excuse me. Just passing through. Don't mind me. Nameless thing, I never noticed that. Well, one of the things, like Dark Souls used a lot of lighting cues to kind of guide you without you realizing it. It used illumination to basically tell you where to go. The most obvious cue is when you first walk into the Asylum Demon's chamber, right at the beginning of the game, and the only illumination is coming from the doorway that you have to kind of run away to. And then you see that message on the ground that says run away. So your eye is immediately drawn to that door opening just by the illumination. There's a lot of illumination clues in there. So one, but again, I just kind of noticed it because I had never noticed that window. The other thing is that the doll wanders. Oh, she's up here now. She has a couple of different places she'll go hang out at. So here's the next thing, and I don't know if this is still active, but if I try to... Yeah, okay. So I can't go to the Tomb of Odin. That bonfire. Why? Why can't I go to the Tomb of Odin? Well, let's go find out. We'll go to the next bonfire in the sequence, which was the Cathedral Ward. Which apparently is the name of the central area here of Yharnam. Cathedral Ward, which is how I got from which is the path that goes from Yharnam to Old Yharnam. But anyway. See, and honestly, it's this kind of crap that I really love in this game, is like discovering shit and like weird things going on and the world changing around you. So, if we head back down to the Tomb of Odin, whatever, because we can't use that lantern. See if they're still here. Okay. Oh, they killed one another. Okay. Oh, nope, there he is. So when I first came back here... There were two guys here. This guy... And a monster guy. And they were fighting each other. And this guy's gonna kill me. I don't think I can take him yet. Yeah. I've been... But they were just sort of fighting there, and now they have invalidated this, that bonfire. I'm gonna come back and deal with that guy some other time, because he strikes me as a little bit powerful. anyway, I just wanted to show that stuff off. And the last thing was, in re-going through all of Old Yharnam, which is where we're going to head now, because that... Oh, no, no, no. First things first. We're going to a little bit more thoroughly explore the Cathedral Ward. Because there's some stuff I missed. Here you are... Come on. Okay. So, we remember this path here. And we went up that way, and we got as far as... There's a cathedral up there, and there's the big yard with the two bell-wearing giant guys. Oh, wait. I didn't mean to have the whip cane equipped. Now, one of the tricks that I've discovered with these guys is if you stay at their feet and roll past them as they attack, or, like, quick-step past them as they attack, so that you're always behind them, you can get in charge attacks on them and pretty much just own them. Because it takes them long enough to recover. Yeah. That it takes them just long enough to recover that they, that you have time to charge up the charge attack. So meanwhile, we never came down to this little patio area, the patio of 1,000 concentric fences. And we're only gonna piss off one ogre giant at a time. Who is still not stunned by being shot in the face. That one attack that they have, where they raise the object high and then bring it down, does not seem to be interruptible. Darn it, I was hoping to do that without pissing you off. Whoop, uh-oh. Back off. I ran out of stamina. That was a mistake. I am using a lot of health here. Whoops. There we go. I don't know why. I suddenly have lost my ability. Whoa. You started creeping up awful close there. Still find those things utterly disturbing. Yeah, so there's this patio here, and I have no idea what purpose all of these little concentric ruined fences serve. This does give a really good view of Yharnam, and just like in Dark Souls, like area that looks like it's part of the skybox is actually part of the game. Like, over there, as near as I can tell, that is the bridge where I fought the cleric beast. And directly below me is the rolling boulder bridge that's on its way to... I should be able to see the Tomb of Odin from up here. Well, I can't get up that side. Alright, I'm having trouble navigating the terrain here. That's okay. Yeah, down directly below me. Maybe not. Don't quite have the layout yet. I am trying to build up in my head a map of this world. Because one of the interesting things with Dark Souls is that as big as it seemed, the world was actually very, very tightly interconnected and a lot small. It covered a lot smaller area than it seemed. Because it was just layered on top of each other. It kept wrapping in on itself. Who are you? Hello? If walk up quietly. Okay, he's not staggered by back attacks. Okay. I see. I'll see your bleed whip and raise you, I guess, is the game here. Let's see if he'll fall for the same trick of staying behind him. Yes! Yes, he does. Wonderful. Flamethrower. Pfft. Who needs a flamethrower when you've got a sword cane? Actually, flamethrower probably would work okay on those guys, except that given their response to the Molotovs, I'm assuming that he is in the same sort of, he's the same species as the other giant, the bell-wearing giants with the other weapons. They didn't seem to be particularly perturbed by fire or bullets. And now I don't know where I am. Wandering, rolling. Oh, I can't leave. Oh, this just reeks of trap. Rolling usually means they want me to defend myself, right? They want me to be ready to dodge. Hello? Anybody behind the urns? Some sort of urn beast? Tentacle Cthulhu urn? Pithoy monster. Earthenware golem. Nothing. Alright. Yet again, my adventure senses disappoint me. Treasure chest at the end of hallway. This doesn't scream trap either. Though, honestly, if it... Ooh, a door also. If it was a trap, I would expect to see more, more, you know, like, dead people. More graves, but... Alright, I was just checking. Oh god, don't shoot me, don't shoot me! Another bloodstone. That message still bothers me, by the way, when you try to open a door and it says closed. I know it's closed. That's the problem I was trying to solve with the open button. If it would say something like locked... Meanwhile, Monkey Hatefire says, it turns out you were the real monster all along, breaking all the priceless pottery. Yeah, so, like, look at this patio of fences. Why all of these layers of fence? Like, what was this place before it was a ruin? What purpose did all of these concentric fences serve? I'm also trying to figure out, like, there's a lot of statues in this game. But you look at these statues. There's a lot of statues of people weeping, people lamenting, and people holding candles. And they're all over the place, and they're placed... Like, they're placed very oddly, and they're in some places where they don't appear to have, like, any space. Like, somebody... It looks like someone came along and put these statues here after the fact. Not like they were planned as part of this construction. Right? So I started to wonder, were people turning to stone? You know, like, I don't know if that's actually a thing, but, you know, it could be. Anywho. Now it's time to go back to Old Yharnam. And I did miss a couple of items in my exploration of Old Yharnam, so we're gonna have to go back and get those before we take on... Oh, maybe I can gain a level. I have enough souls. Royal Freeformer saying, yo, what's up? Yo, what's up?
I must have dreamed. What is it you desire?
Welcome to my stream. Listen, just ground rules. If you know anything about this game, I don't want to know it. I'm doing this completely blind. and I'd prefer to keep it that way. No hints, no tricks, no tactics, no nothing, farewell, no theories. Good hunt. Of course, if you don't know anything about the game, you are welcome to speculate or make guesses or suggest ideas, because then we're all playing blind together. So anywho, back to Old Yharnam. We're gonna give this old town a thorough going over. And then we're gonna see if we can't defeat ourselves a blood-starved beast. Imperial Star Destroyer saying my last comment was in jest. Yeah, no, I figured that. Last comment was, well, this place is modeled after an insane asylum, right? Perhaps to mess with the citizens? Yeah, because I figured you were joking and weren't seriously suggesting that insane asylums purposely place weeping statues around just to screw with the inhabitants. Royal Freeformer saying, I will tell you everything. JK, I'm kind of new to this too. Oh, cool. Yeah, so we don't know what's going on. I mean, I guess at this point, like, the other thing is that I've been trying to pay in my other playthrough, which, as I said, for those of, which I'm not going any further than I've gotten here. I have been trying to pay more attention to the story, and there's a couple. All right, come on. Another one. Also, those guys that I've been calling the cowly skeletons, because they're kind of skeletal and they have cowls on, which is how, you know, that's pretty much how my naming conventions go. Clothing and physical description of creature. In the end, I noticed that they're not actually skeletons, they do have skin. So they're actually more ghoulish. But now we can use this shortcut. Though, let's see. So this is it? Oh shit. And then fall off the ladder, and then crap, fell right into the crow's nest. Swung right over that crow like four times. Damn it! There was another one! Bad Polly! No crackers for you. Royal Freeformer says I call them witches. I think Cowley Skeleton is much more evocative, personally. So I'm trying to think. There was a thing that clued me in that I missed something. Oh, it must be down here. Because I do believe very heavily in just scouring every square inch of the game. Something horrible is running around. Oh, okay. Yeah, it's right down here. There's a horrible to the right. And then there's a horrible behind me. Yeah, okay. So here, like, you can kind of see through this window. There's an item in there, but I can't get up there. So I started looking for alternate entrances to the building. And discovered this segment of hallway. Arthur H.S. is saying, did I kill the mounted minigun guy? I did indeed kill the mounted minigun guy. We were calling him Shooty Pants McBang Bang, I believe was his... is actually the name given. And Royal Freeformer is saying, how many bosses have I killed so far? I killed the Cleric Beast. I killed Papa G. And, let's see. I killed Shooty Pants McBang Bang, and now I have to kill the Bloodstarved Beast. And you can sort of hear a lot of stuff moving around in this place. Once I located this, I backed out rather than exploring it because I wanted, like I said, I want the full blind experience on stream. So I don't know what I'm in for. For all I know, I've just found, oh dear. I seem to have also discovered the Ninja Werewolf Training Dojo. He sidestepped right along with me, bastard. Alright, frankly, I think you have an advantage when you can all approach me from different directions. I claim this doorway in the name of Choke Point. There are a lot of friggers in here. Holy shit, he is a master ninja werewolf because he was actually hiding behind his ally, the Cowley Skeleton. Man, the way of the ninja werewolf is definitely invisibility there, huh? Fortunately, I have the plasma beam of melee weapons here and penetrated. Oh, man! There really should have been something better in there. But, I forgot why they ended up being the reason they ended up being named the Ninja Werewolves was because, when I went down to the Moaning Chapel of Absolutely Nothing Terrible Happening, they decided to all come running at me one after another in the hallway in complete ninja style. Because that is how ninjas are required by law to fight. And the reason is because ninjas are so much cooler than everything else that if they were allowed to fight as groups, basically all non-ninjas would be extinct. So a law was passed requiring ninjas to only fight one at a time or two at a time in certain situations, particularly if the hero has some sort of double weapon and wants to be able to hit both two ninjas at once. The ninjas are allowed to engage twice, two at a time. A rifle spear? Well, that's like the chocolate and peanut butter of death. Maybe. I have been burned before by weapons that sounded cool that turned out not to be. This does not have the same sort of broken, illiterate haiku as the other messages. The red moon hangs low and beasts rule the streets. Are we left no other choice than to burn it all to cinders? Well, clearly you were, because it's not all burnt to cinders. Charred hunter garb. Okay, Farson, another step towards the inevitable flaming sword thrower. Yes, truly, the singularity of steampunk weapons. As we continue attaching one weapon to another with steam and black powder, eventually we will have the flaming sword thrower. Okay, and the other secret I discovered through accidental falling on my other playthrough while I was attempting to engage Shooty McBangbang. It turns out you can get up to the top of the chapel of the Moaning Chapel of Nothing Terrible Happening via this catwalk. The Havoc Engine ragdoll corpses never gets old. And there is an item up here on these rafters. Royal Freeformer is saying, damn, I missed a lot of things in this area. I am, like, when it comes to exploration gameplay, I am an exploration junkie. I scour. True story, when I first played Dark Souls, I love owning strategy guides, though I have a very firm rules about not opening the strategy guide until I've beaten the game at least once. So... damn it, I didn't make that. There was an item up there. So after I finally beat Dark Souls, I went through all of the maps in the strategy guide to see how many items I missed. And there were only like three things, and most of them were in that tree area. Where you have to drop down the inside of the giant hollow tree. Arthur H is saying the strategy guide for this game is gorgeous. I haven't actually bought it yet. Now, I do have a bit of a problem here. Because I am going to have to engage those foes, and gravity is going to help me engage a lot faster than I generally like, and there's going to be that moment of stun lock after I extract my ankles from my hip bones. Yep. Oh, I forgot how many fellas there were down here. Quite a lot, as it turns out. Now, they're breaking all the Ninja Werewolf rules here. Alright. You know, now I'm a bit disappointed in this whole flamethrower thing, because I can't help but feel that this is a situation for which a flamethrower was basically designed, and... yeah, no. Okay, no more flamethrower, dogs are done. I may have... damn it! Is that a statue, or is that one last one waiting by the... he just watched me flamethrower all of his friends. He's just standing in the doorway as I dropped out of the ceiling and went into a murder frenzy. And he's like... I'm just gonna hang back. This guy seems serious. For showing the better part of wisdom and valor, I will allow you to live, my friend. Just this one time, though. Meanwhile, up here, did you... Right. Now, the reason I have to go back around is because I missed that one jump. Just Monkey Hate Fires named it Timothy, the smart monster. I have to go back all the way up to the top because I missed that one jump.
There's no food out there. And many of my friends have been killed. So maybe I'll skip my usual shrieking murder frenzy this time. I'll just hang in here. Pretend to be a statue.
At least this time getting back down to the bottom of the chapel will be less, monster-philic. Monster-centric. I don't know, I'm trying... Monster-licious? Wow, it's weird that I actually... Shit! Ah! Timothy lunged! Timothy waited! He knew it was gonna happen!
That fool is gonna go back up to the rafters again. I'll just wait here and let gravity take its course.
Damn it, Timothy. Timothy earned that, but now we have learned Timothy does not get to live either. Oh, by the way, I found an option in the Twitch, which is the thing I'm using apparently. I found this option to turn down the delay, and I'm using it now. So, if any of you guys notice buffering or different issues, just let me know. Because I was warned that it would cause some buffering, but at the same time, you guys are a bit more in sync with what's happening. At least your random jokes are. And it sort of makes me wonder why it's even an option of, hey, would you like it to be a little bit less inconvenient to communicate with your followers? Check here. You know, it's like, do they also have like an option where they will translate all of the tweets or all of the text messages into a language you don't speak? Alright, we gotta give those rafters another try, because there's an item up there. Alright. Oh god! My chiropractor's gonna give me hell over that! Hey, Derevin, it has been a long time. Welcome to Bloodborne and the adventures of Colonel Erasius. Amnesiac murderer of everything. Okay, see, actually, if I'm smart, since I know I'm gonna have to go this way anyway, I can see. Come down! Came up a little bit short there. All right. Speaking of not knowing your distance. Yes, sidestep me flailing a giant bladed whip. Royal Freeformer is saying you don't seem angry at all, by the way, senior streamer. Well, you didn't see the Sonic the Hedgehog 2006 stream. But no, actually, honestly, the whole angry GM thing is a moniker that has grown out of my tabletop role-playing gaming blog. Whoop! Oh dear! Sorry, fellas. Just bear with me a moment. I need a quick injection, and then I'll be right with you. Now! Oh dear! Well, fuck me! Okay. It seemed like a good plan, didn't it? I'll just go down there and simply murder absolutely everything all at once. I'm sure they won't put up any sort of resistance at all. Most creatures are not even at all reluctant to be murdered. Turns out they had their own plan. I still haven't taken another run at the cleric beast yet. I'm still just trying to get that one friggin' item on the rafters. Because this is the thing, too. As a psychotic exploration-based completionist, now that I know that item is there, I can't not get it. Oh, I have my... Yes, that's the problem. Meant to be using the sword. I always forget which button I have pressed on this thing. these trick weapons. It's sort of the equivalent of having three different remote controls for your TV. Hit the wrong one and the bleed sword cane comes out. Hit another one and the cable box turns off. You never know what you're doing. Reality Freeformer saying OCD for items. Damn straight. I'm terrified of missing content. Like, in my mind, I know that it's just like some useless tempering bloodstone or something. Or like, oh, here's some more bullets for you, even though you have max. And yet, at the same time, there's still that voice in the back of my head that says, well, you know, it's actually probably the flaming sword thrower. That's where they put it. Oh! Oh dear! Oh dear! Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear! Yes, I see you, Three Crows, hiding behind the specter of another player. Plus, you have a serious weakness. Not only do I keep coming back to life, I remember what happened. Derebim is asking, is that your sword turning into a chain whip? Yes! Yes, that is precisely what's happening. It is a trick weapon. Now it's a sword cane. Now it's a bladed chain whip. I also have a gun. For the situations when swords and bladed cane whips just won't do. Oh, Royal Freeformer say my OCD is I refuse to use my items. I'm a hoarder. Oh, yeah. But I might need it later. Is the most dangerous thought a gamer can have. Monkey Hate Fire saying it's a can opener too. Well, to be fair, that's any strong bladed implement is a can opener if you use it. That joke just died. Well, that's why you end like every Final Fantasy game with 6,000 elixirs. While you're still, like, chugging just basic potions every turn. You're basically fighting Zeromus, and it's like, well, he'll probably have a fourth form, so maybe I'd better hold these elixirs. Am I going in the right direction? Where? Oh, there it is. Okay. Alright, I think I can drop down from here. Okay. Jesus! It's like now it's golf. See, this is the thing, I can't get a good run-up unless I could do a run-up and then jump to the side. Oh, this item is gonna frustrate the hell out of me forever. Yes, yes, I hear you all down there! I'm trying to puzzle out the mystery of the scaffolds. I'll come down and murder you in a second. Is there another beam that goes over that area that I'm missing? Oh, this is gonna drive me crazy. I don't know. Well, you know what? We'll come back and try and solve the problem another day. Excuse me, all. Nope, don't get up. Just showing myself through. Oh. I said, don't get up. Oh, out of stamina. Excuse me a second. Need to catch my breath. All right, resume. Game on. Uh-oh. Aha. Yes, I see you there. No. Bad dog. You get the chain. Really? You had to come along too? Well, now that I've murdered everything in there, Oh, Jesus! What is, like, the everything from the beginning of Old Yharnam now just followed me here? Because the thing is, like, you have all been murdered by me multiple times. You would think if I ran past you, like, oh, he's not murdering us savagely this time. Maybe we should just stay here. And yeah, there's Timothy. Here, Timmy. Yeah, I know. Sorry. You know how this has to go now. I don't know, you're not really getting stunlocked very well. Out of Line Kid is saying, what's this about? Your guess is as good as mine, actually. Alright, so what do we know so far? So, I came to Yharnam because I had a disease. Apparently, pale blood. And so they gave me a blood transfusion. And that seems to have given me amnesia. And also then the world was overrun by monsters. From that point on, I picked a direction and just started murdering. And I'm pretty much just gonna keep murdering until the game says I'm done murdering. Oh! You had all my blood echo soul things from before, did you? Huh. Shitty healthcare. Yeah, actually, that may be the theme of the game. Yharnam is basically a place where everybody has access to free blood healing. So clearly this whole game is an indictment of Obamacare. Though actually, no, I have been, like, paying attention and thinking about it. So here's the thing. So, underneath this town called Yharnam, there is a tomb of the gods. And given the references to old gods in some of the lore, I'm guessing that when we say gods, we're talking Cthulhu gods. Not like, you know, not god gods. So, so we're talking Cthulhu gods, not god gods. So then there's this college called Bergenworth or something like that. And they went down into the tomb and they discovered some sort of blood. They discovered a medium is what the term was. They discovered a medium of healing and they brought it back and they started the Church of Blood Healing based around this goo that they found. And now Yharnam is now famous because everybody in the town pretty much uses blood healing for pretty much absolutely everything. And then apparently the hunt. So at some point, I still can't quite make that. And I can't, like, the jumping controls are shit. Okay. Just in the tradition of Dark Souls, the jumping controls are absolute shit in this game. Roll. Okay, yeah. Didn't quite break both legs. Excellent. So you have the run button, which you hold down with the circle, and then to jump, you have to tap the run button. So you have to let up on the run button and then tap it again right away with just the right timing, because if you let up on it too long, you stop running, and then you do a dodge roll like I just did. And considering I don't have a good run-up to that jump, that's it. This is... Royal Freeformer saying, where did you get all this info? I listen, basically, reading item descriptions and listening to the NPCs. For all of my cornball jokes, I am actually paying a lot of attention. One of the primary ones is this guy, Alfred, who is above the grave, above the tomb that gets you into Old Yharnam. If you go talk to him, and agree to cooperate with him, apparently he'll start telling you information about Bergenworth and Yharnam and blood ministration and this founding of the Healing Church. As far as the hunt thing, Apparently it's a thing that just happens every once in a while. It seems to be some sort of endless night scenario where then the hunters come and they kill all the monsters and then the hunt is over. And near as I can tell, it may be some sort of time-space, like time-space sort of a thing, kind of like in Dark Souls how time was coming apart. Okay, I'm done with this now. I will obsess over getting that item some other time. I mean, I'm gonna get it. I'm just not gonna make you watch all the attempts. We've got a blood beast to kill, or a blood-starved beast to kill. And frankly, don't know how I'm gonna do that. Alright. This is the place of the smoke ninja werewolves. Yep, that's right. I remembered you were back there. I like that these ninja werewolves have just kind of like preset off their smoke bombs. Yeah, so I think the medicine is turning people into beasts. Yeah. Yeah, see, that's my feeling on it, because the blood that they have now been using for all of this blood medicine, and probably every citizen of Yharnam had this blood in them. It's having sort of a Cthulhu effect where it's turning everyone into abominations. However, I'm also not entirely convinced that all of the people out in the streets are actually monsters. Like, I know the game wants me to believe that all of those people are beasts or have been transformed in some way. But they're all sort of, you know, like, if you look at what those people are doing, you know, the Torch and Pitchfork crowd are burning werewolves and behaving exactly like people would behave in a situation where the rest of the town turned into beasts. So I'm not really convinced that all those people I murdered are bad guys. Which means that there's probably a really awkward realization coming at some point. I also haven't ruled out the possibility that this is all a hallucination, that I'm hallucinating monsters. Damn it! The problem with the sword whip, or the problem with the whip, is that sometimes it decides that clipping is an issue and bounces off walls, and other times it decides it does not give a shit. Yes, and I know you're up there. I found you last time. Oh, I wasn't close enough for the visceral attack. So that's the other thing. If you backstab something with a charge attack, you'll stun them. And then if you get an attack off and you're at kind of the right distance, then you'll get that visceral attack. The other thing I noticed, at least with the axe, and I think I gotta pay a little bit more attention with the graphics. But the other thing I noticed is that when you do the visceral attack, I don't think you're using your weapon. It actually looks like you're plunging your hand into the monster. So at some point we'll have to see if we can get a good camera angle and check that out. Alright. I think I'm just about back at the blood-starved beast now, if I remember correctly. And I'm still not summoning Alfred, because angry don't need help. Out of curiosity, I did summon, I did bring Father Gascoigne into the cleric beast fight, just to see how much that trivialized the fight. Because kind of in Dark Souls, a lot of the NPC helpers trivialized a lot of the fights. Like, if you brought Solaire into the gargoyle fight, it was like, he would just win the gargoyle fight for you. Alright. Now it's time to use everything I've learned against you. I did bring antidotes, and I brought fire. Oh, and I just used antidote instead of fire. Already, I've made a mistake. Derebim is asking if I've tried offering it blood to eat. Yeah, see, the problem is, I'm full of blood, and it seems to want to eat precisely that. Okay. I also can't seem to get good timing on the stun. Soften him up by repeatedly setting fire to him. Because only in this game is setting a creature on fire softening him up. Well, now he's pissed. Alright, he seems to have... He seems to favor attacks from the right. No. As if to prove me wrong. Alright, he's building up my poison. Yep, there's the poison. That's why I brought this. Alright. I feel like I should be able to stun him, though. There we go. Alright. Now, I just have to get really good at doing that a dozen more times, and I've won. Camera, could you please lock on? Be a lamb. Lock on to the foul abomination. Thank you. Alright. No. Alright, he also seems to be able to shake off my auto lock. Which, honestly... Alright, out of stamina. Let's... Well, now what? Like... Okay, is he just... Okay. Okay, okay. He's just spraying poison now. Shit! He poisoned the fuck out of me there! I'm caught up on the pillar, dammit! All right. I can't get a lock on him. Where? Oh shit, where is he? Take your medicine. Yeah, he really does like that poison attack, doesn't he? Alright. Yeah, okay. Okay, so there's that. I have been warned that this boss is kind of, like... Oh, I have to go back into the dream for a second here. I have been warned that this boss is kind of, like, is a stopping point for some people. No, I think I've only had three. This is only my third attempt at this boss. So I'm not, like, ready to throw in the towel just yet. It took a hell of a lot longer to deal with, Ornstein and Smog, that's for damn sure. But at the same time, I didn't check out... I did find charred hunter gear. Though it reduces my poison resistance, and I can't help but feel that maybe poison resistance right now at this particular point in my life is valuable. I have plenty more antidote, so let's take some more antidote out. See, that's the other thing I discovered, is that while the game does refill certain things for you, like bullets and blood vials, it does not actually automatically take your antidote. Oh, wait. Hold on a second, because I found some other... Royal Freeformer saying, I want to tell you something about the boss, but I won't. That's good, because it's against the rules. Yeah, I also do. I have a rifle spear. We do need to, just see what that's about, don't we? I'm not capable of equipping it. Don't... Oh, my blood tinge is not high enough. My blood tinge is 1 point too low to wield a rifle spear, because obviously you have to have just the right blood to wield a rifle spear. Everybody knows that. Alright, so... Alright, I didn't really look through my other items, I just picked stuff up. Well, fortunately, it's a much quicker run-up now that I'm not trying to get all the other items in Old Yharnam. So we can actually take the short path. I do feel, once again, that, like, visceral attacks are going to be the key, but... So, like, there's other stuff that I haven't figured out. Like, this giant beast pellet, or this beast blood pellet, which grants me beasthood, could not figure out what the hell that was doing. The pungent blood cocktail, which attracts beasts. The problem is not attracting him. The problem is not well... I wonder if he can be poisoned. You know what? Alright. We'll try out some different... We'll try out some different attacks. I'll try poison. I have throwing knives. I have a monocle. I don't feel that would impress him. He comes running at me. He's like, ew, that's a very nice eyepiece you have there. Oh, thank you. Thank you, quite. Found it on... the patio of weirdly concentric fences. Is, oh yeah, I don't know what the hell is up with that place. Like, what were all those fences for? Royal Freeformer saying, what is that green claw thing? It is apparently an expendable one-use knife that causes someone to get... causes a creature to get disoriented in some unspecified way. I only have one of them, and it breaks after use, so I haven't experimented with it yet. Excuse me, I'm not actually here for you, but you were in my way. Meaning no offense. Nope, don't bother turning around. Just don't face in this direction. No one's over here. And you, sir... please, don't trouble yourself over me. I'm just... going in this direction. Almost missed the stairs, and I've got a werewolf chasing me. Alright. Do we want to try poison, or do we want to try giving it a drink? Well, first of all, alright, let's try poisoning it first. It seems to get faster as the fight goes on. It's probably not, like, it's probably immune to poison. now that I come to think about it. Because it doesn't poison itself. Okay. Yeah, it doesn't seem to be particularly perturbed by the poison knives. Go fig. You don't like that, though, do you? Okay. All right. Calm down. No sense getting agitated. All right. That did seem to give me a moment of distraction, didn't it? Now, if only I could take advantage of it somehow by actually not being a bumbling idiot. But I can grab my blood echoes. Alright. I don't feel like that blood thing strategy is really helping me out very much. I think really it's going to come down to the visceral attacks. Which seems to be like the secret to the game. The secret to the game is just... Oh shit. Okay. Yeah, catch! Yes! Good. Have another! Got a cocktail for you right here. Oh, he's got me poisoned. Time to keep the antidote turned on at all times. Okay. Alright. We gotta... He is rather a tough one, isn't he? I see. Yeah, Royal Freeformer saying try the Molotovs. Everyone seems to be weak to that. Actually, it seems like beasts, like the werewolves and stuff, are particularly weak to fire. And non-beasts, like humanoids and undead and stuff, don't seem to be as bothered by it. I don't know if that's a real thing or just sort of a pattern that has been emerging. But, whatever. Oh, okay. That's not what I intended to do. He hasn't figured out that I'm here. I'm like, right? I'm just gonna keep staring at this pillar. Unfortunately, I have no peripheral vision. If anything just stayed perfectly still behind the pillar, I wouldn't see it. Yes, it's you again. I wish I had more of that fire paper that set your weapon on fire, but I lost all of mine. Is that... Oh, that's the Alfred summoning thing. Nope, don't need help. I can fuck this up on my own, thank you! Alright. Let's quickly change the equipment loadout. Poison knives, not really effective. Alright. Actually, if those really do distract him, I don't want to use them up at the beginning of the fight. Because he gets faster and more dangerous as the fight wears on. Yes, yes, I know. Narg, I've been burned and hurt. I'm so infuriated by everything that's... Alright. Alright, get the hell out of the way. Alright, let's try this. Nope, he's already poisoned me. Alright. Put a pillar between us. And mainline some mysterious beast blood. Another one who can just attack through the terrain even though I can't. At this point, I'm not so much fighting, I'm just taking him for walksies. Like, come on, one more lap around the cathedral! Get your exercise, and then go find a spot. Okay, nope. Da Vinci's beard. No hints, no spoilers. He's too fast at this point for the Molotovs. I can't keep enough distance, I just lob over him. Oh dear, he's got... Okay, that's a new one. He's got a grab attack also. Interesting. Mr. Bosnio is saying, I think staying in front of it is not the best strategy. Yeah, yeah, I agree. Being in front of him is a pretty terrible strategy. But at the same time, he gets a say in our relative positions also. And as the fight wears on, he gets faster. So eventually, he gets to overrule me in terms of where we are standing relative to one another. Royal Freeformer saying, damn, he ate your face. He certainly did. All right. Whoop. Take out more of these. Alright. We did get a lot of exploration done. Da Vinci's beard, the people who suggested Molotovs are people who haven't played the game. If you actually know what's going on, I don't want to know. Most of the people in my stream actually have not played this game before. So they're experiencing it for the first time through me. And if they want to make suggestions, that's cool. Though I really don't pay attention to most of them either. Playing the game blind and discovering how to play for yourself is most of the fun. Otherwise, I would just read a strategy guide or just watch a walkthrough. All right, what am I on now? Attempt number 4 or 5? It doesn't matter. Who's keeping count? Let's not fall right this time. I can see how this fight would be a lot of people's Capra Demon, though. The thing that makes them stop playing. Yes, yes, I hear you. I'm not interested. All right. Arthur H.S. is saying Capra Demon is way more bullshit. Or something. I don't know, I have the language filter turned up because I'm the only one who's allowed to swear in my streams. Alright, while I have the moment... I guess, alright, let's give this another try. It did seem to distract him, I'm just not sure that I was able to take good advantage of the distraction. See, it, like, made him lunge way the hell far away, which... Okay. I guess I should keep trying to pick up my blood echoes. Alright, let's... I also can't get off a shot fast enough. I've gotten really good at the parry or the gunshot visceral attack thing, but I can't seem to find his sweet spot. I got a few of them here and there, but I think really that's what's going to make or break this. Because he becomes a real bastard late in the fight. And there's not much I can do about the poison other than just carrying enough antidote. I think... Yeah, I don't know. Alright, back down again. Once more into the breach, as they say. Yes. I know there's a ledge there that I can actually land on and then not lose as much health when I hit the ground. There we go. There, I finally figured it out. Only took me 6 or 7 broken ankles to figure out the pattern there. Let it never be said I don't eventually learn. I have to say, I think, of the two, Royal Freeformer saying I think the strategy is to hit him and not get hit. Actually, I would disagree. I think this, like, that's more of a Dark Souls-y strategy. The strategy in this game is to get hit, and then hit him fast enough to get all your health back, and then run the hell away and yell out an apology from a distance. Alright. While he's far away... Can I actually hit him with Molotovs? No, I can't. I have to be locked on to do the Molotov thing. Alright. Alright. Alright, so the engagement's now open. We both had our opening volley there, as it were. Thank you. Come on. Yeah, the Molotov cocktails do work good. It's just that... It's just, I can't keep him far enough away to get more than one off at a time. Alright. And that's the key, is to have him at just the right distance where I can hit him with a Molotov and I won't lob over him. I've also got a... Whoop, I overshot him that time. Yeah, and that one attack, that's just like, fuck you. Remember those hit points you used to have? Well, they're mine now. Alright. I gotta stop trying to get the charge attacks off. It's just not gonna happen. Get out from behind him. Whoop, it's time for antidotes. And the and the problem is, like, downing the antidote slows you down. So he does so much damage to you in the attacks that inflict the poison. So you're close to him, and then you try to... If you don't down the antidote immediately, you run out of hit points in the time it takes you to run away. And at the same time, if you do down the antidote, you've slowed yourself down, and you don't have enough hit points to withstand his next flurry. I'm also completely out of bullets now, which is just fan-friggin-tastic. Alrighty. Alright, I'm gonna have to get really good at this really fast. Especially because it's been 90 minutes now and I'm... The chain did twice the damage of the cane. Yeah, see, the problem is the chain, though, is slower. And the advantage of the cane is that I can actually get the visceral attacks off. The trouble, though, of course, at this point now, like, I was hoping for the strategy of, like, running past him, and then as he got locked into his little attack cycle, getting charged attacks at his back to stun him to get visceral attacks. But I don't think that's going to happen. So maybe you're right. Maybe favoring the chain is... for the best in this fight. We'll try it. What the hell? I mean, that's what we do, right? We experiment. Should we cheer you up between rounds like a boxer? I'm not depressed yet. I love this shit. This has taken a few more attempts than I generally like. But I'm not, like, depressed or anything over it. I like this. I am very addicted to this game, I'm gonna say that. Alright. Oh, I don't... Alright. Are you a member of the Pedophiles Anonymous Forum? No. What kind of ridiculous question is that? Okay. Yeah, Jess. Yes, I see. You're spewing the poison and everything. Aren't you just completely badass? Okay. Greedy. Alright. Excuse myself here. That's the trick. Don't wait to get fully poisoned. An ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. I got pinned up against the pillar there. Alright. Alright, I'm ready for this now. Come on out. Come on out, give me a lock. Alright. I'll take what I can get. Alright. Alright. Come here. Take this one hit at a time. Just take whatever he gives me. Come on. Mr. Bosnio, I can see you're trying to give me advice right now, but I'm not really in a position to pay attention to it. Shit, it got the grab attack on me. Oh, that thing is death. God damn it. Do not exchange hits with the thing once it starts swinging back off. Yeah, no. I got it too. That's the thing. Okay. So here is the key to my strategy here is I run past him because he gets kind of committed to a lunge. So what I've got to do is I've got to charge him. Oh shit, I'm running short on blood vials. So what I've got to do is I've got to kind of dash past him. And then use that advantage to get a few quick whip shots off. While making sure that I stay directly behind him. Don't overshoot and get around him to the point where I'm in front of his attacks. And then back off. But then, have you seen what I've been fighting lately? You think you're a thing, cause you're not. Got much bigger prey than you that I've almost killed 5 or 6 times. You know what would be interesting too, is like, imagine like the AI was learning. Like every time it comes back to really you're gonna come on, I'm on my way to the boss, couldn't you just let me have this one? And honestly, it really is the poison that just makes this fight shit. Thank you. I almost feel like, okay, I'm gonna get brave and fuck around with the strategy even a little bit more here. Damn it, I shot past him. There we go. Yes, yes, you're very frightening and old. All right. Shot past him again. All right, I gotta watch that. All right, it's time to switch to the whip now. I got my one visceral attack. That was the best I was gonna get. Alright. Though maybe I should focus more on the R2 attack with the whip. Don't go back, go forward. Don't go back, go forward. Never go back. Going back against this guy is death. You can't back out. You cannot back away from him. Alright. Alright, now he's using the terrain. And I'm pinned in a dead end. That doesn't have an outlet. Crap. He's just about at the point where he's gonna explode again. All right, fine. Oh shit, okay. Don't grab. I'm slow per- Fuck! Damn it, that was really close. Damn it. All right, so I have a strategy. But like I said, now, at this point, the resource issue is going to become a problem. One way or another, I'm kind of hitting my time limit. So this is... So this is probably my last run at this tonight. For better or for worse. Glucose 98 is saying, so is this game difficult, unlike most? Yeah, this game is, it's very trial and error based. It's in the same vein as Demon Souls, Dark Souls, not so much Dark Souls 2. But yeah, it is. The key issue with the game is not, like, yeah, it is hard, but it's a weird kind of hard, because it is a fair kind of hard, and it is built around a couple of very particular engagements. For one thing, it is exploration and discovery based. Another thing is that it's built around trial and error gameplay. That is, that you have to keep kind of practicing and perfecting strategies. It gives you a lot of tools to use, a lot of different maneuvers and strategies, and a lot of different ways to play it. And then sort of expects you to perfect them. And to adapt to different situations. Because inevitably what will happen is you'll get good at one strategy and it'll cease being effective. Like, you'll run into something that just somehow, some way, invalidates your best strategy. Now, I don't know why I can't actually get the visceral attack off with backstabs now. But I'll take this. Yeah. Okay. Alright, okay, it's time to switch to the whip. I'm backing up! That's against the rules! The rule is go forward! Always go forward! As we learned in Meet the Robinsons, go forward. Keep moving forward. Okay. Now I'm moving forward, but I'm not facing him, so it doesn't count. And I don't want him in a position where I'm pinned between him and a wall, either. Don't go forward in such a way that you're trapped. All right. Whoops. Okay, that was kind of my fault. Yeah, the whole pungent blood cocktail thing, that ship has sailed. Number one, I'm out of them. Number two, I wasn't very impressed by it the first time. Fuck me. Alright. That's enough for tonight. I gotta run. Alright, that's fine. Like I said, we made a lot of progress in the getting here and cleaning up some stuff behind us and picking up items, so I'll grab some more blood vials and bullets and everything. Kill a crustacean. How is that a spoiler, the shit? Look. Here's the deal, kill a crustacean with my stream. I'm playing this game because I like to play games where I have to learn and discover and figure things out for myself. I appreciate that you're just trying to help, but if I wanted help, I could just open a strategy guide or watch a Let's Play. So if you have any insight into how to beat the bosses or any strategies or even what the story is about, I'm not interested in them. I want to find out for myself. Most of the people in the stream have not actually played the game before. So, Out of Line Kid is saying, when is the next cast? Yeah, I am picking up way too many new people lately that I can just keep doing this at random. So, okay. Let me take a look at my schedule. Because I've just been kind of streaming at random as I've had time. But it's getting to the point now where I really have to just figure something out. So I'm going to say, next cast will be Friday night at 8 p.m. Central Time. All right. Oh, shit. I just bumped the buttons. That was the worst, too. Like, You ever do that in Dark Souls where you put down the controller and it hits the R2 trigger and then all of a sudden you attack an NPC and then it becomes aggressive forever? Yeah, because I've done that. Actually, wait, strike that. I'm just looking at my schedule. Friday night's no good. Probably won't be until Sunday night. Sunday night will be the next stream. Sunday night, 7 p.m. Central Time will be the next stream. I'll put a reminder up on my graphic and do all that shit. Anyway, thanks everybody for hanging out. It's been a lot of fun. Yeah, Sunday night, 8 p.m. Central. All right. Does she aggro if you shoot her? I don't want to try. I don't want to aggro my level up person.